Missouri. Second meeting of the year. Kansas won the first one big. Cole Aldrich will jump with Lawrence Bowers, and Tyshawn Taylor takes it for Kansas. There's the entry pass to Cole Aldrich. The double team from Zaire Taylor knocks the ball loose. They try to go underneath, and it's taken away by Bowers. This is Kim English, number 24. Into the corner. Back outside. Zaire Taylor passes on the three. Jumper is good. Inside the arc, Lawrence Bowers puts Missouri on top.
Vern Bowers has only made three of his last 17 shots in the two prior games. Nice to see him get a quality look and knock it down here early.
Here's this aggressive Missouri defense, but they find Cole Aldrich, and he is fouled after the slam dunk. So Kansas gets Aldridge off to an early start.
Nice job of sealing down against that zone defense that time by Cole Aldrich. Did an excellent job getting his body between the defender and the ball, and then finished right away. No hesitation there.
Three-point play for Aldrich. Kansas on top by one. Here comes Zaire Taylor, one of three seniors in the starting lineup for Missouri. Kim English, the sophomore. Screen from Tiller, jumper, English, no. Rebound, Aldrich. Tyshawn Taylor takes it all the way up and under. Off the glass, no good. Offensive board, Morris. Defensive board, and that one was saved off the foot of Zaire Taylor.
Tyshawn Taylor, an excellent defender for Kansas. He can guard just about any position on the wing.
Back outside, this is Kim English, probably the best pure shooter on the team, followed by Henry, off the glass, and good.
Right on cue. You know, when the game's away from here, he has struggled, but at home, that was a rock. Young fella, you've got to bounce it at least one time before you try to get to the rim.
One of the basic rules of basketball initiated by a former coach at Kansas, James Naismith.
Already two turnovers for Kansas. That'll be something to keep an eye on, Vern. Missouri really wants to turn the Jayhawks over then capitalize on those turnovers.
Yes.
You know, in the first meeting, they did force 23 Kansas turnovers, but they shot so poorly that they never really were able to make Kansas pay for those mistakes.
There was in that game as well a huge rebounding edge.
It was 2-1, 56 to 28 in favor of the Jayhawks. And as a matter of fact, in that one, Morris and Aldrich combined for 38 points and 36 rebounds. Actually, it was both Morris, the Morris twins, and Aldrich. Between the three of them, they had 36 rebounds and 38 points.
Inbound pass goes to Tyshawn Taylor, getting his seventh conference start this afternoon. There's Aldrich again, no roll, but the tip is good.
Just too big that time for JT Tiller, who had inside rebounding position, but wasn't able to come up with the orange. Missouri really has to do a good job of spacing the floor and knocking down perimeter shots.
Here's English, penetration, nice block. Knocked away by Xavier Henry. Quickly up court, Kansas. Henry at the other end. That one's taken down by Bowers. And here comes Missouri. No numbers. Entry pass. And a foul called on Aldrich.
What a terrific effort by Bowers here. Ramsey makes it tough for Xavier to get the shot up. And as a result, he's not as elevated as he would have been. And that gave Bowers time to come and deny it. Good hustle by both players there for Missouri. Ramsey to impede the progress, and then Bowers to bang it off the glass.
Oh, you could see that coming. Taylor went back, got the ball, and the tip, no, on the rim.
Vernon, it is so difficult to control yourself when you're in position to get a tip in and that ball is hovering along the cylinder. And clearly, Morris got it while a piece of it was still on the goal.
5-4, Kansas leading. This is Taylor, no. And Morris, Marcus Morris goes up to get the rebound.
Boy, he's been terrific in conference play. I think he's played at an all-conference first-team level. 14-plus points, about 9 rebounds a game, and doing an outstanding job.
Skip pass and a jump up to 3. Nope. Chase down, out of bounds, Kansas ball. Aldridge on the bench. And Markieff Morris, the other of the twins, joins his brother. So Marcus and Markieff both on the court now with Henry, Sharon Collins. Collins off to a very slow start in senior night, that big win of Kansas State. He was one of his first 10 in that game. Wound up with 17 points. Nice touch pass, Taylor. Henry, mid-air adjustment. English has it for Missouri.
Well, Kansas doing a nice job transitioning back and allowing Missouri just one shot, and that's it.
Collins, there's Bowers. Thrown outside, it'll be Kansas ball yet again.
With an eternity remaining, we'll keep you updated. West Virginia by 2. Meanwhile, back to Columbia, Missouri once again. Vernon Clark.
All right, Greg, thank you. There's the missed shot, and Missouri grabs the missed shot. 5-4, Kansas with an early lead. Tiller back outside to English. And Bowers. Ramsey, one of the 3 seniors. Here's another, Zaire Taylor. The floater, putback is good.
Bowers has been all over the place, Vern. He's had a block, he's come up with the rebound at the defensive end, and that time, an excellent tip in.
Into the corner. Henry passes on the 3. Sharon Collins has it now. A little stutter step, backs outside.
Pretty good footwork that time by Keith Ramsey. Showing you some good defensive posturing there.
Henry, air ball. Ramsey has it. Finds Zaire Taylor, spot up 3. Off the mark. Offensive board, Bowers again, of course. Here's Tiller. Got the touch. Inside the arc for 2. Bill Self calls time. Let's once again go back to Greg Gumbel.
All right, Vern. Under 20 seconds to play in Philadelphia. Once again, Gus Johnson, Greg Anthony.
Good from the perimeter. Reynolds has to hurry. Picked it up. Fisher for 3. Oh, pure! Oh. And we're tied at 60. 7.7 to go. Here comes Ebanks. 4 seconds. He's not looking at the clock. Let's it fly. Oh. And we're heading for overtime in Philly.
Wow.
So they go extra sessions in Philadelphia, West Virginia, and Villanova. Let's send you back to Vern and Clark in Columbia.
All right, thank you. We're back at Mizzou Arena, 8-5, with 14-14 to go in the first half here. Brady Morningstar off the Kansas bench. So also is Tyrell Reed, the first 2 subs for Bill Self. Here's Morris. Morningstar. That one tipped. Missouri will force it. English. Got it. Ten-five. 6 unanswered for the Tigers.
And those unanswered points have been fueled by questionable shot selection by Kansas. They get it inside. Cole Aldridge scored the first 5 points for Kansas by getting the ball inside. That time Morris gets it inside. Prior to that, Kansas had missed 6 shots in a row, Vern, because they were taking challenge jump shots without moving the defense. I think that's part of the reason you saw Bill Self go to his bench and bring Reed and Morningstar in, because Xavier Henry had tried to force it a little bit offensively.
Two subs come in now for Missouri. Steve Moore, number 32, with the goggles. And Denman, Marcus Denman, high-scoring sophomore. Almost the sixth man on this team.
Yeah, he is. I mean, he plays starters minutes, but he is a designated sniper coming off the bench. Excellent three-point shooter and a really good all-around player. Plays with tremendous pace and poise and is outstanding from behind the arc.
Back, it's in the hands of Zaire Taylor, splits the two defenders. Nice dish. What a beautiful find.
You don't get much better than that. That is what we call a room service dime. Be ready to catch and finish after all that work Taylor did.
Reed for three. Got it.
3 points.
Tyrell Reed hitting 40% from three-point range this year. Bowers saves it. There's the pass in the corner for English. Yes.
Beautiful. The extra pass, Vern. Denman had a good shot, but he knew his teammate had a better one. You always want to go from good shot to better to best, and the extra pass gives you a chance to do that.
English has 7. Now Mike Dixon, a freshman, is going to come on for Missouri. And Ramsey's going to come back. Zaire Taylor gets a rest. So does Tiller. So the two senior guards on the bench.
This is just what you like to see, a lot of shuffling and substituting, right, partner?
Oh, I love
both
it.
Sides. Yeah.
I love it, yeah.
Keeps you limber.
It's my favorite thing.
Yes, sir.
Here's the trap. Collins over and back. That was Stephen Moore who came out to help with the trap on Sharon Collins.
And they got him in just the spot you don't want to get to if you're handling the ball. That's in that corner, that triangle between the half-court line and sideline. And that's where Sharon picked up his dribble. And as a result, another turnover for Kansas.
That's 5 turnovers in the game, and the basket counts. Denman.
Well, Missouri's starting to find some room inside, man. That's just a tough finish. He's going to his left, a right-handed shooter, shooting against his body right into the defender, and was able to get it up and down. So a terrific start here for Mizzou.
And Denman at the line. Whoops.
A kind of alligator on that one, Vern.
Hill ball, possession arrow, Missouri. Michael Dixon, freshman, out of Kansas City, Missouri. Denman, also out of KC. Denman, spot up three. Nope. Tyshawn Taylor for Kansas. Jayhawks down by 7. Morris lost control of it, saved by Reed. Quickly over to Taylor. Blocked. Lot of hustle plays here for the Tigers of Missouri. Let's go to Greg.
So the Mountaineers and the Wildcats in overtime, under 2 minutes to play. We'll keep you updated. Back to Columbia, Vernon Clark.
All right, Greg, thank you. Back here in Columbia, Missouri, Cole Aldridge, who had been on the bench for the last 5 minutes or so, is fouled on the entry pass and the attempted shot. Tiller with the foul. Missouri on a 13-5 run in the last 4 minutes. And there's the ever-present defense of Steve Moore. In the corner, Ramsey got a hand on it, but it got into the hands of Morris. And Markeith Morris puts it off the glass for 2.
Well, Kansas has had success throwing the ball inside, either to Aldridge or one of the Morrises, when they've not turned it over. Missouri's been very active with the hands. It has already force five turnovers.
Denver, no. Aldridge, rebound. Try to go over the top, and they did successfully.
Yep. Well, they've gotten all of their buckets in the paint, have the Jayhawks, and that's exactly where they should be looking to attack. Missouri, not a very big team. They're scrappy, they're athletic, but they're not very big. So if Kansas takes care of it, they can get what they want by throwing it inside, either over the top or directly into the low post player.
Moore. Nope. Kansas rebound. Reed dishes left side. Taylor misses. Here comes Tiller. He'll force the issue. Takes it speedily. And then it's blocked. I think Aldridge got his hand on it.
I think he may have. That time JT over penetrated. Got too deep. You like the burst. You like the aggressiveness. But he needed to pull up about 2 feet sooner.
Tyrell Reed for three. Nope. Morris.
That's seven baskets for Kansas. Six of them have been in the paint.
And the margin has been cut to one with 9:34 to go first half.
And again, the size advantage that Kansas has along the front line with both Morris's and Aldridge is something that you would expect the Jayhawks to exploit all afternoon.
Nice penetration and dish, but the shot is missed by Denman, and another Kansas rebound.
And those are the kinds of shots Missouri has to make.
Right.
I think they've got to make 7 or 8 3-pointers to have a chance to pull the upset here. And Denman has gotten a couple of nice looks that haven't gone down.
Henry with a miss from three. Rebound Ramsey, 3-on-3 now. Denman. They'll come back outside. Ramsey for three.
It's one and done.
Yeah.
And again, Missouri plays a lot on the perimeter. Good hustle there by Denman. They don't really have a true post-up player, so you don't expect the Tigers to be able to compete with Kansas on the glass.
Moore with another block. Multiple substitutions for both teams now. Let's see, Zaire Taylor, Kim English, both back on the floor. And now we're going to see Miguel Paul, number three. He'll replace Tiller for the Tigers.
Well, the Tigers have gone 3 minutes without scoring, Vern, after leading 17-10. And they've not been very efficient from behind the three-point line as you take a look at Robinson. Thomas Robinson stepping onto the court for the Jayhawks.
Comes out defensively on Taylor, now goes back inside. Here's Miguel Paul, English. Zaire Taylor. Bowers, number 21. Guarded by Marcus Morris. English. They're now 1 of 9 from three-point range. Steal. Now they've got numbers. Collins hurries back. To no avail. Nice spin move. Wow.
Terrific move that time by the youngster, Thomas Robinson. With a nice little drop step and reverse pivot.
Pump fake. Taylor finds English.
Over penetrated.
Yeah.
He had somebody open at the top if he just reverses it quickly.
19-18. Let's go.
We'll keep an eye on the final 41 seconds of overtime there. Let's send you back to Mizzou, Vernon Clark.
All right, Greg, thank you. 7-10 to go first half here. Miguel Paul defensively picks up Sherron Collins. Now here's Brady Morningstar, Tyrell Reed, Thomas Robinson, number zero. And a little pass up into the air close to the basket. And Marcus Morris cans it. And Kansas has fought back with a 10-2 run to take the lead.
They've been able to do a lot of damage inside. That was a well-executed play as they spaced the floor, had crisp player and ball movement, and then got Sherron Collins in the lane off the pick and roll. Kim English going to get himself to the foul line as he was fouled hard inside. Surprisingly, Missouri is only 2 points down when you look at total points in the paint. Good job here by Kim English, aggressively going to the front of the rim. So he'll have a chance to give Missouri a one-point lead if he can cash in from the line. But Missouri has to make perimeter shots, Vern. We talked to Mike Anderson yesterday. He said, we've got to knock down some perimeter shots. They're doing a good job getting into the lane, getting some points in the fast break. But at some point, they've got to be able to knock down some of those three-point attempts. Only 1 of 9 from the line. And they average 7 makes per game from beyond the arc. And in conference play, the Tigers are shooting 36% from the three-point line. They need to get up around those norms to have a chance here today, in my opinion.
Morningstar gets a screen from Morris. Collins. Taylor goes for it. A little floater in the lane. Marcus Morris.
Well, that's 12 points between the Morris twins, and Cole Aldridge has 5. So 17 of the 22. And I know Robinson had a bucket. So 19 of the 22 points for Kansas from the front line.
English has the ball, guarded by Morningstar. No shot there.
Got to get that ball to the other side.
It's going to be over and back.
Yep. Yep. He has stayed too long on one side of the floor, Vern. English has to be quicker with his move. He's going to beat a guy off the dribble. It has to be 3 dribbles or less, not 4 or 5. And if he can't do it, then he's got to get the ball to the middle of the floor and get it swung to the other side to try to move that defense. There you see Markieff Morris off the bench. One of the best 6 men in the country, Vern.
Right.
When you consider Markieff Morris, what he's able to produce, right about 7 points and 5 rebounds a game. Hovering around 20 minutes of action.
There's his twin brother underneath, and Morningstar dives for the loose ball. Bowers picks it up. Zaire Taylor.
What hasn't Lawrence Bowers done this first half?
Amen. Here's English with the entry pass, and there was Collins fronting Ramsey. Back in the Morton, nice pass. Really quick.
That's why you move the ball, Vern. Defenders can't keep up with a fast-moving ball. They can't do it, and you get quality shots. And Moore showing you his range. He can do work in that paint, but he stepped out a bit and sprayed that triple.
And let's go back and spend a moment with Greg Gumbel.
All right, Vern, this is what just happened in Philadelphia. Final seconds of the first overtime. Deshaun Butler of West Virginia with the runner. 5.7 seconds to play. Timeout there. Villanova trailing West Virginia by a score of 68-66. Back to Columbia, Vern and Clark.
All right, Greg, thank you.
Woo-hoo! Kind of tight there in Philadelphia, isn't it?
What is it about Gus and games? I've never seen anything quite like. He's a wonderful announcer.
Yes,
and
he is.
Always winds up.
I would just consider him blessed and highly favored in that regard.
And the rest of us envious. He gets the barn burners every year.
Yes, he does.
Believe me, it's noticed.
Well, a nice little prelude to March Madness,
yes,
which is
indeed
right around the corner here.
And
we're in tournament mode already, partner.
Yes, indeed. Zaire Taylor, number 11. 24-20. 14-3 edge now. Kansas in the last few minutes. Well, that was a falling down prayer, and then the follow goes in.
And it
the
looks
answer.
Like Sherron Collins. Is that Collins on the? No, that's not Collins. Who is that? One of the Morrises?
Morris, yes.
Markieff. Well, he took a shot. I'm not sure exactly what got hurt. Okay, here we go. Stop, slide, activity. Okay. He took a tough fall trying to break his fall. It could have been his arm, or looks like he's working that shoulder now.
Cole Aldridge will replace him.
Aldridge for number 21, Marquise Morris.
Yeah, he jammed that left shoulder. Let's hope it's nothing serious, Vern, because he's been very productive all year long and was having an outstanding day here today.
4:45 to go. First half of play. And Kansas by two. Collins. Quick. Off the rim. Taylor at the other end. Nice pass. Denman comes back outside, however. Aldridge is a force down there.
He will. He will discourage you from coming in there. There's no doubt about that. He has seven blocks in the first meeting earlier this season.
Here we go. Ramsey.
Great trap here. Terrific trap there by the Tigers.
Reed from the corner.
And that was a nice pass by Aldridge.
Yes, how about that little follow? Brady Morningstar. And it's a two-point edge. Kansas by two, 3:42 to go. Morningstar again for the Jayhawks. Back outside. Tyrell Reed. And a blocking foul underneath. And once again, let's go back to Greg Gumbel in our New York studios.
All right, Vern, this is how the action wound down in Philadelphia. West Virginia by two, 5.7 to play in overtime. What are the Mountaineers doing? The one guy Villanova wants to take the shot, Scotty Reynolds from three for the win, doesn't fall. Reynolds finishes with 17 to lead Villanova.
JT Tiller, Zaire Taylor, Kim English, Bowers, and Keith Ramsey. 26-24, and at the line, Tyrell Reed. One more.
Well, Reed has come off the bench and been very solid. That's his fourth point. He knocked down the three-point field goal. He averages 4 points a game in conference play.
And one of the factors in this first half, Clark, bench points. This is a strong point of Missouri. They get 30-some points per game off their bench.
Yeah.
So far, Kansas 14-2 in bench points.
Yeah, a big part of that is Tyrell Reed, and also Markeith Morris having a very strong first half here today. Matter of fact, Tyrell Reed had a season-high 14 in the last meeting against Missouri, a comfortable Kansas win. You see the points in the paint. I call those PIPs even so far.
You know you got a close game when the pips are even. It's always been a barometer for me. 28-24. Oh, goodness. Morningstar. Now, Xavier Henry's got it. Here's Mike Anderson in his fourth year as the head coach at Missouri. Longtime associate of Nolan Richardson. Mike came here from University of Alabama, Birmingham. He was with Nolan for 17 years at Arkansas. Now they'll work the perimeter a little bit here.
Zone defense here by Missouri. Everybody thinks about Missouri being a pressing, trapping type of team, looking to make things chaotic, but Mike Anderson's team will mix it up defensively. But if you're going to zone up, you don't want to give up the baseline. They're lucky that Aldridge didn't finish that.
Here's Dixon, right side. Denman off the bench. Bowers has had a terrific first half. Ramsey over the top. Well, as best we can, we'll bring you up to date. A game summary here at Mizzou Arena. Sold out, second meeting between these two.
Early on, it was Missouri forcing turnovers and Cole Aldridge doing it inside a little bit. Lawrence Bowers has stuffed the stat sheet. He's been everywhere at both ends. He's already got 8 points, 80% of the way to his season average already. He's also had a couple of blocks, a few rebounds, a steal. But right now, this is a critical juncture here, Vern. Missouri has not been able to knock down good open perimeter shots. They trail by four. Free throw missed. They've got to come up with that rebound, and they don't.
And Henry fights for the rebound, then puts it off and in the basket.
It's a six-point deficit now. Missouri really has to get something going offensively over the next 2 minutes.
Six unanswered for Kansas. Jayhawks come in as the number two team in the country, 28-2 for the year. Had a big win their most recent encounter against Kansas State. And here's another basket by Marcus Morris. His brother Markeith, by the way, just before all of you joined us, went down hard and injured his shoulder. He's back on the floor, however.
Yeah, they're both out there. As a matter of fact, this lineup has been pretty productive for Bill Self, having both Morrises out there at the same time. Another missed opportunity. Denman having a tough first half. He's gotten a couple of open threes that haven't gone down, and that time a makeable shot, even though he was challenged, doesn't go.
This is for three.
See, yes. That's why I said this was a danger zone.
Yeah.
This team here, the Kansas Jayhawks, they understand when the tide is turning or tilting, and they're trying to seize this one by the throat.
Now let's take a look at the Applebee's ultimate matchup. In 1997, Kansas 22-0 and ranked number one in the country when they came to Columbia. In the first overtime, the Jayhawks had a shot to win, but Jacques Vaughn's jumper off the mark. In the second overtime, Missouri trailed by three. Jason Sutherland tied the game when falling out of bounds with 5 seconds left. Then Corey Tate's jumper the difference as the Tigers upset the top-ranked Jayhawks 96-94. Coming up on AT&T at the half, Greg Gumbel, Seth Davis, all the scores and highlights and the latest NCAA tournament news, plus an AT&T Naismith watch update. It's all coming up on AT&T at the half. Bill Self, all they've done is won national championship with Bill. Another Big 12 title. That's the 53rd league title going all the way back over the different conferences for.
And it's also the fifth consecutive regular season.
We've got a three-game edge here in the Big 12 after that big win. There's a falling down shot by Zaire Taylor. Kansas, the only two defeats this year, we were reminded, both on CBS. We saw them lose at Tennessee, and then last Saturday they got thumped thoroughly by Oklahoma State. Here's Collins, another one for the only senior in the starting lineup.
And he has really waited patiently for his opportunities to shoot the ball. I think he's only taken a couple of shots. One was a drive, that one was a wide open three after the gamble defensively by Missouri. And it's been a long drought for the Missouri Tigers here. Credit Kansas with solid defense, attacking the paint inside and challenging every shot. 3 second difference between game and shot clock.
14 unanswered for the Jayhawks, and that has quieted the sellout crowd at Mizzou Arena. Denman, tough first half. A steal. Collins at the other end. Ramsey back, lays off. Basket is good. 16 in a row for the Jayhawks of Kansas. That'll cause you to jump. Greg Gumbel.
Upson and then Sharon Collins scored all 8 of his points in the last 4 minutes of that first half, part of a 16-zip Kansas run.
And we get set for the start of the second half. Yeah, no sooner had you said dangerous point in the game for Missouri, and kaboom.
It happened that way in Lawrence as well. Kansas has such an advantage inside that they've been able to exploit that, and the inability of Missouri to knock down shots. I thought Kansas was very disruptive at the defensive end. They were determined and disruptive defensively, and I thought they were deliberate offensively in getting that ball inside and really taking good shots for the most part.
And they start by going right inside to Cole Aldridge. And they have now scored 18 unanswered. Here's Tiller back to Taylor. Two senior guards. Ramsey, the other senior in the starting lineup. Here's Kim English. He's got a pure stroke.
He does, and that's the answer for Missouri. They have to score the ball so they can get into this pressure. You can't press when you're taking the ball out of the net all of the time.
Now, Clark, let's take a look at the Dove for Men first half stats.
Well, you see the field goal percentage, huge for Kansas. Rebounds plus 10, and then 16 zip. That run to end the half over the last 4 minutes. Now, when you start knocking down threes, if you can do that, you can get back into a game quickly. Look at Bowers work that weak side glass.
Wow, he's having a good game. Here's Taylor at the free throw line. That's 5 in a row. After Kansas had 18 unanswered on either side of the halftime break. Taylor on Taylor. Zaire on Tyshawn.
Nice to have a 6'8", 6'9 guy in Marcus Morris who can help you bring the ball up the court.
Little pick and roll. Collins heaves it away. Among the other things Kansas did in the first half, they went 5 minutes without a turnover.
Exactly. After having six in the first 7 minutes.
Jumper, he lost it. That was Tiller into the hands of Xavier Henry. Marcus Morris. Missouri ball.
Little miscommunication that time. Morris was expecting Aldridge to seal and go to the rim. So another opportunity for Missouri to shave points off the deficit. Burr, you want to chop it in the 4 minute segments when you're down. You want to win the 4 minute battles, be it by 2 or 3 points. If you're Missouri, you just want to be on the positive side at every media timeout in terms of points produced.
English lost control as he drove to the basket, but it went off Kansas. Opportunity gone, but they get a second chance.
You can't have too many empty trips if you're Missouri. You've got to get good shots every time.
Ramsey wants some help. Doesn't get it. Turnover. Here's Sherron Collins. Pull up jumper. Taylor off the glass. No. But the follow from Cole Aldridge.
Big fella. That was a nice pull up by Tyshawn Taylor, though. The fact that he didn't try to drive it gave Cole Aldridge room to attack that miss.
There's English. No. Off the mark. Taylor with the offensive board.
And somehow Missouri has to try to make this a chaotic, fast-paced, high-octane kind of a game. It can't be deliberate as it was in that first half. It's got to be crazy. They've got to make it a little bit like a playground game on a Saturday afternoon where it's just up and down and only the strong survive.
And that is what they are known for, right? That style of play.
But you got to make baskets,
yes,
in order to speed up the tempo with your defense.
Baseline rejected. Bowers again.
He's everywhere.
Yes, he is.
Ubiquitous.
Ooh, I like it.
That means all over the place at all times.
Anytime you can get ubiquitous into a broadcast, it's a
you
good
like
thing.
That?
Yeah.
Nice pull-up by Tyshawn Taylor. Better follow by Cole Aldridge. That's just chasing that pumpkin down in transition. All the Missouri defenders locked into watching the ball. Nobody kept Aldridge off the glass.
Tiller. That's blocked by Morris. Nice feed to Ramsey. Tough shot. And Tyshawn Taylor has it for Kansas. Aldridge takes a seat on the bench. So Markieff Morris and his twin brother Marcus both on the floor now for the Jayhawks. The sophomore is out of Philadelphia. Empty pass. Zaire Taylor. 3-on-3. Nice dish. Oh, tough. Tiller gets it.
They have to make this game like Sloppy Joe. Good tasting, but messy. That's what Missouri has to do. Has not waned for this team to get a, have a chance to win it all. He's going to have to elevate his offensive production in my mind. Defensively, he's been good. He's rotating. He's bothering shots. He's blocking shots. He's been pretty good on the glass, but I think he's got to be a little more shot hungry for Kansas to be the best it can be.
How about that out of bounds play? Collins drives it and is fouled, and he will shoot two. Foul is on Bowers. Time call.
It down, boy. We got a little bit of the tournament flavor go on prior to this one. West Virginia and Villanova going to overtime. The Mountaineers prevailing in that one. And maybe still have an outside chance at perhaps grabbing that fourth number one seed, maybe.
Cole Aldridge back from Kansas. We had a really nice chat with Bill Self last night. And we talked a little bit about the tournament, the number one seeds. Bill Self saying, okay, you guys, which teams do you think can win six in a row?
Uh-huh.
He granted that Kansas is one of those teams.
That's right.
He picked Kentucky and Syracuse.
And help me out. Didn't he say Villanova for the fourth?
He thought Villanova certainly would be in that conversation. I think you'd probably look at maybe perhaps Duke.
Right.
West Virginia. I still wouldn't discount Michigan State if they can get it right. In this landscape where there aren't really that many dominant teams, Kentucky clearly is in that group. You mentioned Kentucky and Syracuse, I think. So.
Yep.
And then once the brackets come out and you look at matchups, you might throw another two or three teams in there. Ohio State playing extremely well right now with the right type of draw they've got, perhaps. I think the player of the year in the country in Evan Turner. Good active defense here by Missouri.
Aldridge. Yes, Ramsey was there. Loose ball. Well, Xavier Henry went down to the floor and got it. And a foul is called on Missouri's Kim English. That's his second. Mike Anderson, a little disappointed with that call. Potential number one seeds. Anybody you'd add to this?
Well, no, not right now. Those three teams at the top are locked in for the most part, I think. And then after that, I think one of those other three, we had Duke, Villanova, Ohio State on there. Kansas State might be a team if they were able to run through the Big 12 tournament that might warrant some consideration.
Entry pass, Morris. Guarded by Bowers, off the glass, too strong. Ramsey, and it finds the hands of Zaire Taylor.
And then we mentioned West Virginia as well as an outside chance.
Yes. Ramsey, got it. Well, you talked about winning four-minute increments.
It was 9-4 in the first four-minute segment. Right now, it's 2-0 in the second one. Missouri.
Here comes the pressure. Aldridge. Hard screen on English. Bowers. Back to Collins. Weaves in the lane, off the glass, short. Missouri ball. How about this second half with the Tigers?
Well, it starts with shot making, Vern, because it allows them to get into their pressure. And it also gives you confidence. You need to see that ball go in the basket consecutive times to get yourself going, to get your defense set, and to get this building alive. So all of those things are predicated on putting the ball in the hole. And that's what Missouri has been able to do here in the start of the second half.
JT Tiller back to Kim English. Steve Moore is on the floor, sets the screen. Ramsey will pass on that shot. Into the corner, English. Closely guarded, yes.
Nice closeout by Morningstar.
Sure was.
He was there aggressively and on balance.
7 on the shot clock. Taylor turns it around outside. Tiller, tough shot. And
good
that's
defense.
Tipped by Aldridge, yes.
Good team defense that time by the Jayhawks. Now can they settle down offensively? They've been a little out of sync, much the way they started to get the game here at the start of this second half. Turning it over a bit.
Aldridge, Morningstar, taken away, another steal. English. Collins with the foul. English goes to the line. Run your brackets online for free with Bracket Manager. Invite your friends, fill out brackets, and Bracket Manager does the rest. Sign up now at cbssports.com/brackets. English gets the first of two.
Taylor.
Tyshawn Taylor back. Aldridge out. Sharon Collins out.
Vern, it's a carbon copy of what we saw at the beginning of the game.
Yes.
Kansas with 5 turnovers here in the first 6.5 minutes. Missouri with 2. Missouri had a 7-point lead.
Right.
Because of the turnovers forced and the fact they took care of the ball and made a few shots. That's what's going on right now. Kansas has to find a way to get some rhythm. The lineup now with both Morrises out there was pretty effective in the first half because they both can handle the ball pretty well. They're big enough to do work inside, but versatile enough to come outside, make perimeter shots, and also help with the ball handling against this pressure.
As Steve Moore just got called for a really cheap foul.
Yeah, Mike Anderson didn't like it. He wants his players to be aggressive, but to be smart as well. And typically they are. They apply that heat without doing a lot of fouling most of the time.
Morningstar, nice slip. And a foul called against Missouri.
Yeah, Keith Ramsey was do-si-doing his opponent that time. He had his hand right around his waist. Now, keep an eye on that, folks. Five team fouls already from Missouri. Only one for Kansas. Kansas is not a bad free throw shooting team. Right around 70% as a team.
Morningstar touched it.
He was indecisive.
Yes, he was.
You always get the ball. Don't ever wait around when you have a chance to squeeze the ball. That's a pet peeve of mine. If you have a chance to grab the ball, don't swat it, don't bat it, put both hands on it. He did not, and as a result, it went off his chest and he turned it over.
Here's Tiller. Quick hands of Tyrell Reed, but Steve Moore saves it for Mizzou. Jump stop in the lane. Got it, and a foul. They have clawed and scratched and fought, and the Tigers are back in this one.
Acting like Tigers, JT Tiller. That's what he does. Get that shoulder down, get around that defender, concentrate and finish through contact.
Tiller was Mike Anderson's first recruit. He actually recruited him to UAB. And then the offer came to replace Quinn Snyder here at Missouri, and Tiller came with him and will graduate in May. A 16-2 Missouri run. And this Tiger crowd at Mizzou Arena is roaring. Is fouled.
Nice take. Good aggressive take by the senior. Sharon Collins, the winningest player in the history of Kansas basketball. National championship, multiple Elite Eights, four Big 12 conference championships.
Yeah, very emotional at the senior night ceremonies with his mom and his uncle there.
Yeah. Talked to him before the game.
Yeah, he said it was really,
really hard.
Really hard.
Yep.
Really tough.
Vern, I did not have the privilege of going through a senior day at the collegiate level because I left Ohio State after my junior year. I did go through a dramatic one as a senior in high school, and it drains you. It is emotionally draining when you've had a positive career, a positive impact on your school and your teammates, and you see all of those people there to celebrate that. It is really hard to ramp up emotionally to go out there and play at your best. And to Sharon's credit, he struggled early, but found a way in the second half to play more like he typically does.
125 wins with Sharon Collins in uniform, and the putback is missed. 3-on-3, Tyshawn Taylor. Offensive foul. Steve Moore took the charge.
Boy, I'm not sure. I thought that was a pretty good move. We'll get a chance to review it. Tyshawn Taylor. Oh, I think that should go to Tyshawn. When that defender doesn't get squared up and that offensive player is able to slide away from him, I think he should get the benefit of the doubt there. Fortunate break for Missouri.
Little pick and roll. Ramsey slipped. Couldn't get it to him. Zaire Taylor. English. Back outside. Jumper Taylor. No. He's having a tough day. Uh-oh, somebody hit the deck.
And hit it hard, Vern, and he's still not up.
Yep.
Yeah, that kid's weapon that was. One of the Morrises. I can't tell which one. Boy, that was a wicked thud.
Yes, it was. Well, it's to our right, and we could feel the desk move when he hit it.
Oh, my. Oh, my goodness.
Oh. You see the back of his head. Time has been called while they tend to Marcus Morris. Back at Mizzou Arena, and Marcus Morris assisted to his feet and goes immediately to the locker room. And here again was the play in which Marcus Morris, the back of his head on the brace of his desk, And the team doctor there, Bill Self, was over. And he was helped to his feet and walked almost without assistance to the locker room.
Which was very good to see.
Yep.
Obviously, we'll find out later the extent of it, but great to see that young man walk off.
NCAA March Madness on Demand is back. Every game from the first round through the championship will be live online for free. Find out more and sign up for the notifications at NCAA.com. So the extensive timeout taken because of the injury. And Marcus Morris, one of the two twins. There's his brother, Markeith Morris, who had a shoulder injury, much less severe as it turned out. That was midway through the first half. Marcus Denman, number 12, is on the floor now for the Tigers of Mizzou, the sophomore out of Kansas City, Missouri, guarded by Tyrell Reed. Back it goes to Tiller. Steve Moore comes out to set the high screen. Aldridge follows him back. Oh, nice, on the line. Yep. Well, the plan was great. The execution left a little bit to be desired.
Yeah, Kim English forgot where he was, didn't recognize how close he was to that end line and stepped on it.
Only 9 turnovers for Missouri. Here's Xavier Henry. This time, Moore does not get the call.
And he got an injury as a result. And he's not moving too well here. Let's take a look. Over the top against the press. And you get that close to the goal trying to take a charge. Although I thought Moore was in better position that time than he was against Tyshawn Taylor. I mean, he got that one. He was almost squared up. Well, good job by Xavier Henry to slide away from him just enough to warrant the call. But I think Moore was too deep, too close to that imaginary restricted area around the goal.
Moore does pick up his third foul, and that gives him a seat on the bench. Lawrence Bowers has come on for the Tigers of Missouri. And the freshman, Xavier Henry, at the line. Zaire Taylor comes back. Senior guard, started his career from Staten Island, New York, and started his career at Delaware. Coaching change, he started 1 year there, and we had a chance to chat with him extensively yesterday. He graduated in December. Zaire Taylor taking 3 courses in graduate school right now.
Yes.
It's a wonderful success story for him.
It sure is.
Mom and dad are here for senior day. He said they don't get a chance to see me play very often.
And he also talked about how early on in his career, as Bowers is denied by Aldridge, that he was about basketball and not so much about the academics. As Sharon Collins, that's all basketball right there. I can tell you that. That's all hoop there. The power pack right to the rim, but Zaire Taylor has really grown up under the influence of Mike Anderson.
7 unanswered. Here's Tiller. Rebound Ramsey. There's the jumper for Taylor. Still can't get it to go down. He was the hero of the win in overtime at Iowa State. Matter of fact, he had a game winner against Kansas a year ago, Dib Taylor.
Yeah, he sure did. One of 4 or 5 in his career. He just had another one Wednesday night against, well, Tuesday night against Iowa State.
Here's Collins. Throws it away. Bowers. Tiller's there. Oh, dear. And Denman with Collins out on him.
Boy, that was a botched opportunity.
Yes,
2-on-1. You just want to spread out, make that one guy try to defend you. I thought Bowers had a chance to take it right to the rim himself.
Tiller. Cheeky. Cole Aldridge gets the foul, number 45, I think.
Well, just to finish up that thought on Zaire Taylor. Nope. How Mike Anderson has had a positive influence on him. The young man graduated in December. He's in grad school. And at one time, academics was way down on his priority list. And the light came on. And here he is, hoping to be a coach one day, looking to get a master's. And that's what it's about.
Yeah.
To see a young man grow through the opportunity that collegiate athletics can give him, to grow personally, not just athletically. Vern, I talked about these four-minute segments, okay? Right. Missouri won the first two, 16-6. The only problem is when you're down so much, the other team just has to hit a couple of timely baskets.
You mean like that one?
Yeah, just like that, to keep you at bay. Because it's an uphill battle when you're trying to come from a double-digit deficit. So Missouri has to keep pounding away. Do they have enough left to knock down some threes and to still defend and rebound at a high level to get all the way back?
There's a three, and Bowers, here comes Taylor, three on two. Here's a three. Boy,
that's devastating. That is demoralizing if you're a Missouri fan. Look at Sharon Collins exhorting his troops, the Jayhawks.
Tigers came out early moments, second half, got within four.
What a look at this drive by Sharon Collins. That's eye level, folks. Tight handle to go along with that strong, quick, explosive body. And that was a thing of beauty there.
Taylor, English, killer. Tyrell Reed takes it away.
Boy, he's been a huge factor here. A couple of threes knocked down in transition. That time, excellent defense and a forced turnover.
Morningstar. Tiller from behind can't get there quickly enough. Reed. This time, Tiller's right in his face. Hit back. Good. Tyshawn Taylor. And I don't want to give up on Missouri's opportunity here, but it looks like they've run out of gas.
Your instincts are telling you that.
English with an air ball. Taylor, two more.
Yep, your instincts are right, partner. Because Kansas is continuing to keep the throttle down. They're not trying to play and protect the lead. They're trying and expanding it.
Time call.
Conference play, 7 3-point field goals a game. Sharon Collins was a major catalyst in the 16-zip run that the Jayhawks enjoy at the end of the first half, because he scored 8 of those points. And then he had a big two-pointer during this 15-2 run. So there you see how he's packed his points judiciously into selected times during this game. He's been very patient and self-controlled, Bernie. He's not tried to force the issue very much at all. And that's what you expect from a senior with his ability.
English gets one more.
Well, they basically put the mute button on this sold-out crowd in Mizzou Arena.
Yeah, they were energized when Mizzou climbed to within four at 44-40, but then this run by Kansas quieted the crowd.
So when you've got the firepower that Kansas has and the size and the balance and the good defense to get consecutive stops, all that equals spurt ability. And we've seen a couple of significant spurts by Kansas here today, one by Missouri, but that might not be enough to give the Tigers a chance to get back into this.
Morningstar. Nope, but the putback is right there. Tyshawn Taylor.
I really like the way Kansas has attacked. You know, talking to Bill Self last night, he said, we know they'll come after us and pressure us, but we can play behind the pressure if we take care of the ball, and that's what you've seen happen a little bit here in this significant game-changing and perhaps game-deciding run that we're seeing Kansas put forth now.
Michael Dixon with the miss. So on the floor now for Kansas, Tyshawn Taylor, Markeith Morris, Morningstar, Cole Aldridge, and Tyrell Reed. A 28-2 Kansas team. Into the corner, Taylor for three. Yeah.
Boy, he's come alive here in the last few minutes as well. But that's what I mean when I talk about multiple options and weapons. Tyshawn Taylor, Sharon Collins, both Morris's, and it looks like Marcus is actually at the scorer's table about to come in, bro.
Sure does.
That's great news. That's a terrific sight.
Sure. concussion and that we wouldn't see him for the rest of the afternoon. How about that?
Yes, sir.
His second personal foul.
English back at the line. Well, Missouri, this is the sixth year in this arena. They have a 3-2 edge. And they play well here.
Yeah.
They lost one game this year, Texas A&M in Big 12 play. They had won 32 in a row. That's still well behind what Kansas has done at the Fog, right? 59 in
a
row?
It's a bunch. Yeah, I think it is 59, yeah. And actually, this will be, if it holds up, which I think it will, this will be the first time in 6 years in this building that Missouri has lost the last regular season game at home.
Right.
They've been 5-0 coming into this one, but they have faced a superior team here today that played at a high level for about 25 minutes, and that was enough.
Aldridge is fouled. Tomorrow on CBS begins with 60 Minutes Presents, followed by a new episode of The Amazing Race. Then don't miss the hit series Undercover Boss and Cold Case tomorrow only on CBS.
Actually, the Kansas Spurts have been a much shorter time than that. They've been, well, 3 and 4 minutes in the first half.
Yep.
They went on that 16-0 run, and then this run continues now over the last 5 minutes. So really a strong stretch of 10 or 11 minutes. Solid another 12 or 13, but very impressive in a 10 to 12-minute stretch for Kansas, which is, that's what's allowed the Jayhawks this comfortable margin.
Lane violation on Bowers. Well, Bill Self, he said something I thought was interesting last night. It's been his experience that it's not a bad thing right before the tournament begins to have an incident so you can reestablish control of your team. There's an up and under Michael Dixon.
Well, a lot of coaches feel that way, Vern, as Dixon gets that one to go down in terms of adversity sometimes stealing the resolve of a team.
Right.
Giving the ears of the players more to the coaches in that situation. And I think that's what Bill was speaking of. But sometimes, as long as you have the other ingredients now, you've got to have size and talent, playmakers and all of that. So if you do stub your toe in some form or fashion, it can give you a chance to regroup and rededicate and get locked in and focused for that run to what you hope is six wins.
Bowers, nope, short. Rebound Kansas. Here's Morningstar. He's got Taylor to his left. Taylor is fouled. He'll go to the line. Well, one team has earned a berth in the field of 65 so far. Cornell, they gave Kansas all they needed.
All they wanted
in midseason.
And they made 20 of 30 threes last night. They've made about 10 a game on the year. They've got a big guy in Jeff Foote, balanced scoring. They feel like they're ready not only to be in the tournament, which they are, they're ready to win a game.
Well, they can relax and watch the selection show and find out where they might be. That's a week from tomorrow. 70-47, Aldridge out. Bowers is going to get a rest as well.
Well, he's had a fantastic day today, and we didn't mention Justin Safford, an outstanding forward from Missouri, tore his ACL a couple of games ago. We pointed out how Kansas is dominating in bench scoring, but Mike Anderson has kind of had to retool his team in the absence of Justin Safford. And that's put Lawrence Bowers in the starting lineup. He typically would be a guy coming off the bench for Missouri.
Dixon. Boy, they just cannot can the long ones.
Yep, it's been a tough day from behind the arc. And when you're undersized and outmatched on the front line, your only recourse really is turnovers and points off turnovers and knocking down three-point shots. And the Tigers, 2 of 18 from behind the arc today.
That's off the rim.
But I tell you, you got to give Kansas some credit defensively. There have not been, there were some decent open looks early, but a lot of the shots that Missouri took throughout this game were challenged. And that's a credit to excellent defense by Kansas.
Well, they're going to wind the regular season up 29 wins and 2 defeats, one at Tennessee, once at Oklahoma State. Clark, how does Bill Self, how do they go about their diligence for the Big 12 conference tournament?
Well, I think anytime you get between the lines, you want to win. And you want to do it you want to be playing good basketball. So each opportunity they get, as Tiller was able to finish in transition, each opportunity they get to sharpen up their game is important. Now, with that being said,
yes,
if for some reason they did not advance in the Big 12, I don't think you'll see anybody on the Jayhawks bench or staff crying about it. But at the same time, you want to perform at a high level and try to win. So that'll be the focus. There won't be nearly the emphasis placed on it that has been in the past, because they've clearly shown their superiority during the regular season in a very good and tough Big 12.
Shot clock violation. And time has been called. 3:25 remaining. My goodness.
Oh.
My goodness. The final game in Freedom Hall. Well, Kentucky plays tomorrow.
Kansas will be your new number one this week, I would think.
I would think so, too.
Yeah, and they've actually held that spot more, or they've held it longer than anybody else, and deservedly so. The Jayhawks have been pretty consistent for the most part. But I think it points out the fact that there are no dominant teams, and even dominant teams during the course of a season will get beat on the road, even at home. So it makes and sets up for the madness we've come to love and enjoy over the years.
Taylor, finally. Zaire Taylor, his first from three. But it's only the third made three in the ball game for Missouri.
Well, the Tigers average 79 points a game on the season, 74 in conference play. In both meetings against Kansas, they've been well below those numbers. 65 in the loss in Lawrence, and they most likely won't get to 65 here today.
Has Missouri earned a berth in the day?
I think so.
Okay.
There's enough quality,
yep,
in terms of the wins on the profile of the Tigers to be a part of the field of 65.
Well, Tyshawn Taylor's just, he continues to excel in this second half.
Well, a balanced attack, five in double figures for the Jayhawks. They've shared the wealth.
And they are about to sweep Missouri for this year. Here's Denman. That's for two inside the arc. 1:49 remaining. Whoops. I think Xavier Henry had the breath knocked out of him. Well, tournament here, the first and second round sights on Thursday, Saturday, Clark.
Yep, bouncing around a little bit. We'll be anxious to see where we end up.
Yep.
And then we go Friday, Sunday. There you see the locales. And then the regionals. Thursday, Saturday sights right there. So that means, guess what? The ones that I didn't circle are,
yeah,
what? I'm waiting for you.
Well, deductive reasoning would indicate it would be St. Louis and Houston.
Well, and also the day of the week, though. I mean,
oh, I'm sorry.
Okay, so I'm giving you another chance.
Friday, Sunday.
Oh, there you go. Thank you, partner.
Logic was never my strong point.
You recovered nicely.
Well, pressure was on.
And within the shot clock, too.
Oh, goodness. 1:43 to go. Xavier Henry. One more.
Very impressive performance by the Jayhawks. I think as much defensively as for how they attacked during those critical segments at the end of the first half, and then when Missouri had made a run, the Jayhawks never let up off the gas pedal. They just continued to push the ball in transition, throw it inside, space the floor, and knock down transition threes. I mean, it was a very impressive road performance for the number one team in the country.
I thought it was interesting last night during our conversation with Bill Self. The emphasis is he placed on his, here's the three pointer, in and out, rebounds, Abby Henry. The emphasis he placed on the need for Kansas to get elevated play from their two stars.
Yeah, that's a must if you're going to win it all. Cole Aldridge and Sherron Collins. Because he feels like he has the other elements as we take a look at what's following us.
UCLA, Arizona State. Arizona State with a chance for a tournament bid, I think.
If they win the Pac-10 tournament, they'll be considered. But I don't know if there's enough on the profile in terms of the body of work. As you look at who they might end up being compared to as you settle it down to those final few at-large selection spots. And then the conference tournaments have some impact on how much that last, those last few spots expand or contract based on who wins some of your other conference tournaments.
Now here's a footnote to this game as well. Over the course of its long and rich tradition, this will be the 1,999th victory for the Jayhawks.
Wow.
They're one away from joining two other noted programs with 2,000 wins.
2K.
Yeah, Kentucky got there first.
And then North Carolina, right?
Rebound, here's Miguel Paul, number three, right side Dixon. Quick jumper for two.
Michael Dixon.
Final 34 seconds. Tyrell Reed.
Boy, he did a nice job off the bench, didn't
he?
Another strong effort. He's actually enjoyed seeing the Missouri Tigers this season. 14 in the first meeting. What's his point total today? I think he's double digits, isn't he?
We're about to check.
Okay.
Robinson.
Robinson with the basket. We just got Chuck Gardner alerted.
Tyrell Reed, he's got.
Yeah, there you go. 11 points.
There we go.
That's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the University of Missouri.
Kansas wins it 77-56. For Clark Kellogg.